हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी टेक एंड रिवाइज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर एनसीईआरटी एक्सरसाइज, व्हिच इज व्हाट? अलजेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशंस. एंड इन दैट चैप्टर वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द सम इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट रिलेटेड टू व्हाट इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ अलजेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशंस. वी डिस्कस अबाउट द लाइक एंड अनलाइक टर्म्स. वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द व्हाट इज प्रोसेस टू एडिशन और सबट्रैक्शन ऑफ दैट expressions, and also we take and solve some important questions of your NCERT exercise based on algebraic expressions. Okay, now dear friends, today we are going to discuss and revise a very important chapter of your NCERT exercise, which is comparing quantities. Dear students, in that chapter there are so many topics included in that chapter. Just like first of all, we comparing quantities means in that chapter we discuss the questions based on ratios. We discuss the question based on ratios. Then also we in that chapter we discuss about the question based on percentage. Question based on percentage. We in that chapter we also discuss the questions based on buying and selling of an object, means question based on buying and selling of an object, means the questions based on selling price or cost price. And also in that chapter we discuss the question based on simple interest. Simple interest. Okay, dear students, in that chapter there are so many topics included in that chapter. Okay, so dear students, first of all we discuss some important concept and questions related to ratios. Okay, dear students, one of the most important thing is that we always compare the similar quantities. Like we compare between the kilometer and meter, because of both units represent the same quantity as distance. And we never compare the mass of an object and the distance of any two places, distance between them of any two places, because of both quantities are different. Dear student, we compare only the similar quantities. Okay, now dear student, we first of all we take and solve some important questions of your NCERT exercise based on ratios. Okay, let's see. Now your question is find the ratios of the following. Find the ratio of the following. Okay, and here dear sir, we take first topic of that chapter, which is ratio. And now we find the ratio of the following, and your first question is what? 15 kg to 300 gram. Second one is what? Rupees 8 to 150. Sorry, 50 paise. Okay. And third one is what? Third one is what? 30 days to 40 hours. And third one is what? Third one is what 15 kilometer to 1500 meter. Okay, difference. These are the some questions based on ratios. Okay, now dear student, we take and solve. Now look, all that questions dear student, we compare between the similar quantities, because of, let's see, in that figure this is in kilogram, this is in gram. So dear students, gram and kilogram represent the same quantity as mass or weight of an object. Okay, Now look the second part of this question, which is rupees and paise. Dear friend, that questions also represent the same similar quantities as rupees. Now this is 30 days to 30. We find the ratio of the 30 days to 40 hours. This one that that values also. This is days and this is hours. That quantity always already discussed represent the same quantity as hours or time. Okay. Similarly, this is kilometer. This is meter. That values also represent the same similar quantity as distance. So this one we always compare the similar quantities. Now we take and solve the first part of this question. Let's see its solution. We take the first part of this question, which is what? We find the ratio of 15 kg to what? 300 gram. Okay, now since we know that, first of all, we know that in 1 kilogram there are 1000 grams. Okay, in 1 kilogram, restaurant, there are 1000 gram. Okay, now since that is required ratio, then required ratio is what? Let's look. This is 15 kg upon 300 gram. So first of all, in that type of question, first of all we convert the quantity into the similar. Here we convert the similar unit. So we can change 1 kilogram, we put as 1 kilogram as 1000 gram. Okay, now look here. We write as 15 into 1000 gram upon gram, gram cancel to each other. 2020 also cancel to each other. So we get what? 15 into 10 upon 3. 3 1 the 3, 3 5 the 15. So 10 5 the 50 upon 1. So the required ratio is 50:1. The required ratio is what? 50:1. This is our required solution of the given question. Thus, dear students, in this way, you can solve that type of question. Now, similarly, we take and solve the second part of this question. Let's see. This is what we find the rupees. Since right, we know that. In rupees one, there are 100 paise. Since the required ratio is what? Rupees 8 upon 50 paise. So, look. We write in this way. Now we convert the rupees into the paise. So we write as what? 8 into in rupees 1 is 100 paise. So we write as what? 100 upon 100 paise upon, we write 50 paise as it is. 50 paise. Now look, this is paise cancel to each other. No, 50 to the 100. Now we get what? We get as 8 into 2 upon 1. 18 to 8 to the 16. Upon 1, thus the required ratio is 16:1. Thus the required ratio is what? 16:1. So this is our required solution of the given question. Okay, dear friends, so you can solve all the questions of your NCERT exercise based on ratio in this way. Okay, dear friends, similarly, we take and solve the third part of this question. Let's see. Now we take and solve the third part of this question, which is what? Which is 30 days to, we find the ratio of 13 days to 40 hours, no? 40 hours. Dear friends, look. First of all, we convert into the same unit. So we know that in 1 day there are 24 hours. So since writing this way, we know that in one day there are how many hours? 24 hours in one day. There are 24 hours. Okay, dear friends. Thus, the required ratio does the required ratio is what? Does the required ratio is what? Look, 30 days to 40 hours. Now what I do? Now first we convert into the same units. Now we can write 1 day is equal to 24 hours. So 30 days is equal to what? 30 into 24 hours. So look, we can write 30 into 24 hours upon, we write 40 hours as it. Now hours cancel to yourself. So we get what? We get as 30 into 24 upon 40. Now 0 cancel to each other. 4 1 is 4. 4 6 are 24. So we get 3 into 6 upon 1, that is 6 3 is 18 upon 1, that is 18 is to ratio 1. This is our required solution of the given question. Okay, dear students. So in this way you can solve that type of question. Okay? Now, similarly, we take and solve the third last part of this question. Let's see. Third part is what? We find the ratio of 15 kilometer to 500 meters. Dear students, first of all, we know that we write, since we know that in how many meter in 1 kilometer. So there are, dear students, you know that there are 1000 meter in 1 kilometer. Na? So you write it. So since we know that in 1 kilometer, in 1 kilometer there are 1000 meter. Okay, in 1 kilometer, in 1 kilometer there are what? How many meters? 1000 meter. That is, the required ratio is what? What is 15 kilometer rising in this way upon 500 meter? Now we can convert kilometer into the meter by the help of that relation. So we get what? 15 into 1000 meter, because of 1000 meter in 1 kilometer, so 15 kilometer in 15 into 1000. Okay, now 5500 meter rise, that is it. Meter cancel to each other, dear students. Now 2020 cancel to each other. 5 3 are 15. So we get what? 3 into 10 upon 1, that is 30 upon 1. Thus the required ratio is 30:1. Thus the required ratio is 30:1. This is our required solution of the given questions. So, dear students, in this way, we take and solve some important questions of your NCERT exercise based on ratios. And now clear the concept of that topic. Okay, dear students. So, in this way, dear students, first of all, you revise all the questions which we discuss in that class based on ratios. Then after, you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on that topic. Now, dear students, we are going to discuss the some important your next topic of that chapter, which is what? Percentage. And we take and solve some question based on them. Let's see. Now, dear students, we take the next topic of that chapter, which is what? Percentage. The symbol of percentage is this, in this way. We represent the percentage in this way. Dear students, this is also, first we clear the concept of percentage. Dear students, percentage means per hundred. Percentage means per hundred, means if we write 1%, it means is that 1 upon 100. Okay, dear students, this is the concept of percentage. Percentage means per hundred. If we write 1%, it means that 1 upon 100. Okay, if we write 5%, it means that 5 upon 100. If we write x percent, so this means that x upon 100. So this is the basic concept of percentage. Now we take and solve some question based on that. Let's see topic. Now if we write a question, convert each of the following in percentage, in percent. And first one is what? 0.75. Third, second is what? 25. Okay. And third mean one is what? Means we take 2 by 3. Suppose that. In that question, we convert the following, each of the following in percentage. Okay? Dear friend, one important concept of that topic, just I discussed about it. If we have 1 upon 100, then you can write 1%. The concept of 1 upon 100 is per 100 means 1% per 100. So we can write 1%. Now, in order to convert the any given value into the percentage, first you must be multiplying both the numerator and denominator by 100. In converting any number, rational number into the percentage, first you must be multiply both the numerator and denominator by 100. So look, we take first part of this is 0.75. So first of all, in going to convert it into the percentage, we must be multiply by both the numerator and denominator by 100. Okay. Now look, we multiply the given numerator, so we get what? 75 into we write 1 upon 100. And just I discussed about that, 1 upon 100 means what? 1%. So we write as 75 into 1% as 75%. Thus, in this case, students, so the required answer means the percent, we convert the percentage 0.75, we write as percentage in is 75%. Okay. Now we take and solve the second question. Let's see. Second one is 25. Dear friends, here also we apply the same process. Look. Okay, we multiply both the numerator and denominator by 100. So we have what? 25, 100 into 1 upon 100. And 1 upon 100 we write what as 1%. So we write as 25 into 1%. So we get as 2500%. So this is our requirement. Okay, now similarly we take and solve the third part of this question, which is what? 2 by 3. Similarly, here we also multiply both the numerator and denominator by 100. So we get what? 200 upon 3 into we write 1 upon 100. And 1 upon 100 means what? 1%. So we get 200 upon 3 into 1%. That is 200 upon 3%. This is our required solution of the given question. Okay? Thus, dear students, in this way you can solve each and every questions or few NCERT exercise based on percentage. Now we take and solve some other type of question based on percentage. Let's see. Now look, our question is, find 20% of, find 20% of 600, rupees 600. Okay, dear friend, this is the question here, this is the basic question of percentage. Okay, now here what we do, we find 20% of 600. Means, dear students, first of all, just I discussed, 1% means 1 upon 100. So, So the 20% means what? 20/100. So look,
the required answer. Let's see its solution. Required answer is 20% of this. Means we will write in this way. 20% of 600. The concept of is what?
Multiply.
The concept of is what?
Multiply.
So we write as 20/100 multiplied by 600.
Okay, the concept of y of in percentage is what? Multiply. Okay, now look.
2020 cancel the so we get what? 20 into 6 means 26 the 120. So the required answer is rupees 120. This is the required answer. Thus, in this way, we can say that the 20% of rupees 600 is what? 120.
Okay, dear students. Thus, dear students, in this way, you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exam based on percentage. Now we take one more question based on percentage. Let's see.
Now we take and solve one more question.
Find the whole quantity.
The question is, this is also very important question. Find
the whole quantity if 5% of it, if 5% of its is 600. This is the question here. Okay, dear students, in that question what we find? We find the whole quantity if 5%, if 5% of it is what? 600. Let's see its solution, dear students. First of all, in that type of question, first of all, you take the whole quantity Vx. Okay? Now look. Let the whole quantity Vx. Okay? Let the whole quantity Vx. That is, what is the concept? Find the whole quantity. Okay? If 5% of it is 600. Means 5% of this. Okay? That is 5% of x. This is what? 600. This is the concept of that statement. Okay? Now, first of all, we take the whole quantity Vx. So, according to statement, 5% of x is what?
600. Thus, we have what? 5% is 5/100 into x is equal to 600. Thus, the value of x is equal to 600 into 100 upon 5. 600 into 100 upon 5. Okay, now look. Here, 5 into 5, carry 1, 2, 5 to the 10, 0. Thus, the value of x is equal to what? 120 into 100, that is 12000. So, the whole quantity will be 12,000. Okay, dear students?
The whole in this way, the whole quantity is what? 12,000. So, this is the required answer. Thus, dear students, in this way, you can solve that type of question. Now, we take one more question of your NCERT exam based on percentage. Let's see.
And we take a question. Meeta. The question is, Meeta saves rupees 4000 from her salary. If this is 10%, if this is 10% of her salary, what is her salary?
Okay, let's see its solution. Dear friends, this is also a very important question of your NCERT exercise. Let's see. Here, Meeta saves 4 rupees 4000 from her salary. If this is 10%, means its saving is 10% of her salary. And find what we find, we find what is her salary. So first of all, we take the let the salary, Meeta's salary be X. Okay, now let's see. Let us consider the Meeta's salary be rupees X. Okay, dear friend, in that type of question you solve in this way. Right, first of all, let us consider the Meeta's salary be rupees X. Then according to statement, then set 2, 3, then according to questions or statement as you wish. According to question, what is the question? Meeta saves 4000 from her, if this is 10%. Means 10% of rupees X is what? Rupees 4000. This is the concept of that question. Means this value means it's saving is 10% of her salary. So we take this her salary be X rupees. So 10% of X is equal to 4000. So we solve it. Let's see. 10% is what? Dear student, 10 upon 100. Okay. Of means multiply X 4000. 1010 cancel to each other. So we get X upon 10 is equal to 4000. Thus the value of X is 4000 into 10, which is what? Rupees 40,000. 1, 2, 3, 4. Thus, in this way, we can say that Meeta's salary is what? 40,000. Okay? Thus, dear students, in this way, you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on ratio as well as percentage. Today we discuss all the important concept based on both topics. So you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on ratios as well as percentage. Okay. Now we discuss some important concepts related to your next topic is what? Problem based on buying or selling of an object. Means a problem based on cost price and selling price. Dear friend, you know that first of all you clear the concept of selling price and cost price. You know that very well. Already we discussed about that topic. Selling price are that price at which we any object is to be sold, and when any other bought by, then this is called the cost price. There are two important necessary condition, if selling price is greater than the actual cost price, then in that condition we get profit. And so the basic formula for profit is what? Selling price minus cost price. Okay, and if you know that cost price is greater than its selling price, then in that condition what is the concept of, if that is the cost price is greater than selling price, okay, then in that condition we get a loss. Now so the loss is equal to what? Cost price greater compared to the selling price. So loss is equal to what? Cost price minus selling price. So this is two very important concept related to that chapter. Okay. And you know that profit percent and loss percent both are find at the cost percent. Profit percent is equal to what? Profit upon cost price into 100. And loss percent is equal to what? Loss upon cost price into 100. Thus, dear student, today's class we discuss two important concepts, which is ratios and proportion, ratios and percentage, and we discuss some important basic concepts of profit and loss, and this is cost price and selling price. Now, in next class, we take the remaining part topic of that chapter, which is problem based on buying and selling of an object, and the cost problem based on simple interest. So in next class we take and solve some important question based on these topics. Now thank you all.